Okay. Well, good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Live Today Show. I am your host, Dr. Cherie, and you are watching the Live Today Show, an interactive show here on CAN TV, Channel 21. Now, this is your opportunity to call in and with your questions and your comments. This is an interactive show, and we want you guys to feel comfortable in calling in. We want you to dial the number at 312-738-1030. Please go ahead and give us a call, and we want you guys not only to just dial in, but we want you guys to feel comfortable and know that this is as much your show as it is ours. Now, the Live Today Foundation is a foundation that provides three things. We provide free compression garments to cancer survivors living with the disease of lymphedema as a result of their treatment process. And we secondly provide education to patients that are living with lymphedema, and we also make them aware of all of their treatment options. And then we also educate physicians on the proper techniques on how to diagnose lymphedema and to make them aware of all of the psychosocial impacts of lymphedema on a survivor's life. Now, I know there are many of you that are looking forward to, again, being able to dial in and to interact with us. Hey, Sherry. We're also on Facebook Live, but please feel free to dial in at 312-738-1060. Again, that number to dial in is 312-738-1060. And for those of you that are looking for ways that you can support Live Today, we want you guys to feel free to go out to the Live Today website at www.live-today.org. Feel free to shoot us an email if you want some additional questions answered, or you're looking for additional information. You can feel free to reach us at info@live-today.org, and certainly feel free to give us a call at 754-220-0234. Now, I know many of you, you're following us on social media. We want you to feel free to reach on out to us at on Facebook, on Instagram, and on Twitter, and that is at livetoday.org. That is livetoday, D-O-T-O-R-G. Now, today we have a very fantastic show for you, I think, because today we're actually going to take a look at the various different stages of lymphedema and to just do a little bit of discussion on what the treatment options are for the various different stages. The reason why I wanted to make this approach today is because we have been giving you not only the premise of what the Live Today Foundation is about, we've also told you the magnitude of lymphedema, that there are more than 10 million people living with lymphedema here in the U.S. alone. That is more than muscular dystrophy, ALS, multiple sclerosis, Parkinson's disease, multiple sclerosis, and AIDS combined, and there are wonderful organizations out there that support those various different disease processes. But it seems like when it comes to lymphedema, we are a population of people that have been overlooked or somehow forgotten. And I, as a physician and as a patient living with lymphedema, decided to make it part of my legacy in creating the Live Today Foundation so that we can make a difference in the individuals' lives that are living with lymphedema. I have also addressed just a few of the psychosocial impacts of lymphedema on a survivor's life, from financial in you know, a woman or a man now having to deal with buying new clothes because he or she can no longer fit the clothes that they were wearing due to the increased size of their affected limb. The individual has to now buy compression garments, you know, every 6 months to replace them. And so I thought that today would be a good time for us to just talk about the various different stages of lymphedema and give you an idea of what it takes to manage them. So let's go ahead and jump in. Remember, hey, Kirk. Hey, Cynthia. So remember, this is an interactive show, so we'd love to hear your questions and comments. Maybe it's just, Dr. Cherie, thank you for all that you're doing, or maybe it's an intense question that you want to ask, feel free to give us a call at 312-738-1060. So let's jump in right now and let's go into the various different stages of lymphedema and the various different forms of management. Now, stage one is the non-visible, what we call the latency phase. Here it's very subclinical. You may not even see any swelling in the affected limb, despite the fact that there is impaired lymph transport. Patients a lot of times, and I went through these exact same symptoms. If you look at the picture that is on the screen, you'll see that you can barely even tell that anything is wrong. But to us as patients, a lot of times it comes across as a symptom of being tight. Your skin feels very, very tight, like it's about to explode or pop open, and your limb feels very heavy, even though you cannot see any active swelling. Now, this stage could go on for months or for years before any edema becomes evident. And despite normal limb measurements, patients with symptoms should seek professional evaluation and often still benefit from management of their lymphedema. Now, when I state that despite normal limb measurements, if you believe that you may be an individual who is suffering with lymphedema, if you feel like your skin is really tight or that your limb is really heavy, these can be the first symptoms and signs of lymphedema. And so you really want to go in, seek professional evaluation, and look into your various treatment options, because prompt management can decrease the risk of the lymphedema worsening. Now, like I would tell you guys, if you want to find out more information about how to support the Live Today Foundation, or you're looking for additional resources that goes into a little bit more detail than what I'm providing for you here, feel free to go out to our website at www.live-today.org. Now, I really hope that you guys are enjoying what we're doing thus far. I do want to move on to our next slide. So take a look at this. So when we go to stage two, we're dealing with mild or spontaneously reversible lymphedema. So now we're at a place. Hey, Brenda, thank you, sweetheart. Mild swelling. Now, this typically starts in like the furthest part of the limb, such as the hand or in the foot. And this is exactly how it started off with me. I started seeing some initial swelling in my fingers, and then it went to to the back of my hand, and then it kind of moved its way up in my arm. Now, this is due to the effects of gravity. Obviously, you can appreciate that if you are walking and your hands are down, obviously the swelling is going to pull this way because of gravity. And so you may notice the inflammation or the swelling initially in your fingers, and then it can make its way up into your hand, and then it works its way slowly up your arm. Okay, so that's what I meant by gravity and where it starts distally and kind of works its way up. My lymph nodes that were destroyed as a result of my treatment are here in my armpit, and they were destroyed here in my neck, and then there are also some lymph nodes along my chest wall. Those were all destroyed as a result of either surgery, the cancer itself, and or radiation. And so even though the lymph nodes that were destroyed are here, the first place where you will notice swelling is distally from the area that was initially affected. Now, going back to the slide, the swelling you'll notice usually will improve at night or maybe even disappear completely, but only to come back during the course of the day as gravity increases the lymph pooling in the affected limb. So if you elevate the affected limb, obviously this can help reduce the swelling. And so patients should promptly seek treatment from a certified lymphedema specialist, a certified lymphedema therapist, to reduce the risk of infection and disease progression. Hey, Pamela, how you doing, girl? And then, in addition to seeking the treatment, and again, let me stress this, this is treatment with a certified lymphedema therapist, not just some an occupational therapist or physical therapist that says, oh yeah, I've treated patients with lymphedema before, there is a special certification process, and that is all you have to ask for. When you are assigned to an occupational therapist or physical therapist, if you've been diagnosed with lymphedema, you simply ask the question, have you been certified in lymphedema management? And if they've been certified, they will either have CLT or they're going to have LANA, so CLT or LANA after their name, and they're going to share with you their certification process. And so you're going to want to make sure you're dealing with a certified therapist. When I mentioned about elevating the limb, I mean elevating the limb literally like this, you know, or you can prop it up on a pillow. Typically for me, I no longer am able to sleep on my right side, so I sleep on my left side, and I put a stack of pillows. When my husband's not home, I use his pillows, and I use them to actually elevate the limb while I'm sleeping, because I'm keeping it above my heart so I can drain the fluid out. If you are walking, I found that by doing this, people sort of thought that I looked crazy when I was exercising and just walking around holding my arms up. So I found that I would take my hands together, spread them out this way, and hold them up. This actually feels better, elevating them both at the same time. One, it gives you a great stretch in your upper back, mid back, and even you can bring it forward into your lower back, but it also makes it look more evident that you're clearly stretching your arm or leaving it elevated, as opposed to you're just raising your hand like you wanted the teacher to pick you to answer a question. And so these are just some of my little things that I'm adding in there to help you kind of get through this process for my fellow patients that are living through the same thing. And so you want to elevate it, and then another thing that is really important is using gradient compression daily. This can help reduce the risk of fluid accumulating. So in general, the goal of management is to reduce the swelling, maximize the function of the remaining lymphatics, and to prevent fluid accumulation. And so when we talk about gradient compression, one of the ways that you can achieve gradient compression is with a compression garment. This is one of the things that Live Today provides free of charge to under-resourced and underserved cancer survivors living with lymphedema. Now, I stressed to you before, and I use the term breast cancer survivors because I'm a breast cancer survivor. However, Live Today is not limited to just breast cancer survivors. We help cancer survivors living with lymphedema. And so, fortunately, at our disposal, we do have garments that you can use for your upper extremity, and we have garments used for the lower extremity. So again, I would say to you this, if you know of an individual who is living with lymphedema and they are in need of compression garments and they are facing financial difficulties, they are underinsured, they are uninsured, and they need free compression garments, have them email us at info@live-today.org, or they can go out to the website at live-today.org and fill out the contact us form and just let us know what they need. We are here to serve them. Now, going back to the last thing on this slide, keeping the swelling down is what really can help reduce the risk of irreversible changes, as well as decrease the risk of infection. And so this is the stage you definitely want to jump on top of the disease process, because here, if you don't, this is where things can begin to take a serious decline, and you now begin to face irreversible changes that you had an opportunity to improve had you jumped on it sooner. Okay, and so now let's go to the I want to take you guys to the next slide. Let's talk about stage three. Now, with stage three, this is where the skin takes on more of a spongy type of appearance, not experience. Well, sometimes it can feel spongy, so maybe that was a Freudian slip. But the skin takes on a more spongy appearance. I mean, literally, just imagine a sponge, one of those sponges that you'd use like when you're painting and you're trying to, you know, sponge paint the various different size holes. It looks puckly, and it pits less when you press gently on the skin, meaning you can press down. And what I mean by pitting, you can press down on the skin and what you in stage two, you could press down on it and gradually you'll see the skin come back up to its normal size. But what happens in stage three, you're pressing and it's not really pitting. It's full of so much lymph fluid that it's just remaining in that tight, swollen state, and now you can't even push the fluid down in your hand or along your arm. So it really is important to monitor and understand the stages of development. And so because of the continued fibrosis and gradual thickening that occurs to the skin because of the lymphatic fluid that's building up in it, it doesn't pit as easily. Then you notice the deposition of extra fatty tissue that's below the skin, and this can occur due to inflammation from the protein-rich lymphatic fluid that is under the skin tissues. Now, at this stage, the swelling rarely reduces with just limb elevation. Patients with stage two can still have significant reduction of their lymphedema with management. And actually, I should have said patients with stage three. Stage three. So you can still have, this is stage three, so that's a typo. That fourth bullet is a typo. You can still have significant reduction of your lymphedema with management at stage three. And while swelling is spontaneously irreversible, it sometimes can improve over time with daily compression and nighttime compression. Now, guys, I want you to remember, if you are following us on Facebook, remember, we want to see you follow us at livetoday.org on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. That is livetoday.org. And remember, you're looking to support us. We need all the support we can get, and or you know someone who can benefit from free compression garments. Have them reach us at info@live-today.org. Because again, like I stated, we are there for them. Now, I am in stage three, and so my swelling is not spontaneously reversible. It does not go away like it used to at night and reappear again the next day. Mine is pretty much there. However, here's the reason why it is still so very important to wear your compression garments and go through the proper treatment with a certified lymphedema therapist with various wrapping. And I intend to share with you guys the manual lymphatic drainage process that individuals with lymphedema go through when they're in treatment with a therapist, and we have to do on our own at home, especially if we've done something to exacerbate the swelling or for whatever particular reason the swelling is worse. And so although my swelling does not spontaneously go away on its own, and elevating it gives me some relief but certainly not significant, the reason why wearing my garments during this form during the day and then wearing my big oven mitt at night is the prevention of infection. Now, here is where I stress to breast cancer patients. Hey, Shantessa, hi! This is where I stress to lymphedema patients why it is so important. I don't want anyone out there to battle cancer or to battle and finally get to the place where you were finally diagnosed with primary lymphedema, okay? What I'm living with is secondary lymphedema. It was caused by something else. Mm-hmm. Primary lymphedema patients, it's a congenital reason, okay? Thank you. And so I want you guys to make sure that you understand that treatment prevents infection. Infection untreated can lead to what we call septicemia, where it spreads throughout the bloodstream, and that could be really bad. That can lead to some irreversible organ damage and or death. So we're not playing here. But my producer told me that we do have a caller. Caller, are you still there?
Yes, hi.
Hi.
Hi, this is Carl from Homewood.
Hi, Carl. How far are you doing from Homewood? Oh, I used to live in Homewood. Homewood, Illinois?
Yes.
Hi, Carl. How are you? What's your question or comment?
Yeah, well, first of all, let me thank you for taking the time to share your experiences with lymphedema and how we can recover from it. And I've learned a lot listening from your show. But I wanted to know specifically about men. Is it common for men to get lymphedema? And if so, what are some of the symptoms?
Okay. And so, yes, if you are a cancer patient and you've gone through cancer treatment, even if it's just simply the removal of the cancer, because tumor growths can actually impact the lymphatic vessels and cause damage to the vessels and therefore lymphedema in and of itself. And so just being a cancer survivor sets you up at risk. And your symptoms are going to be the same as ours. Now, the psychosocial impact for you may be different, meaning men usually, I mean, either, you know, you may be bald or wear your hair, you know, low. So you may still be able to handle your clippers and doing your hair. But if, you know, for women, if they have long hair or things of that nature, their activities of daily living or just going on socially with life may be a little bit different. But yes, men and women are likely to experience the exact same symptomatology. When it comes to primary lymphedema typically occurs more in women than it does men, but it does occur. Same thing with breast cancer. Breast cancer is typically a disease that we see in women. However, men get breast cancer too. As a matter of fact, about 2,500 men will be diagnosed with breast cancer here in the U.S. in 2019 alone. So did that answer your question, Carl?
Yes, and thank you for that. And so another thing you mentioned about is the compression garment. Do you have compression garments that men can wear?
Absolutely. We have compression garments that men can wear. What you're seeing me wear is, you know, there are options that are bling bling and various different color options that say women may choose more so than men. But yes, we do provide, our wonderful partners and sponsors do have compression garments that will work for men as well. So if you're in need of garments, please feel free to go out and email us at info@live-today.org, or feel free to go to our website and fill out the contact form.
Great.
Thank you, Carl. We appreciate you. Continue watching, all right? Fantastic. Thank you so much, guys. Now, any of you out there, hey, Loretta, if any of you out there were using the link that I provided on the Dr. Cherie Facebook page, let me know if you were able to hear that caller, okay? Just give me that feedback so we'll know how it's working. Now, I got one last slide to show with you before our show will end this evening. The last stage is stage 4. Here is where to hopefully none of us get to. We typically see this stage in undeveloped countries and where individuals just, they're in rural areas or they have just been in denial about the entire disease process. The skin is very hard, it's scaly, it enlarges significantly. Sometimes it can actually leak this lymphatic fluid. You see skin lobules that can form. You can see them there on her hand, and patients with, again, this should be stage 4, not stage 3, they can still benefit from lymphedema management, because at every stage, the amount of lymphedema that is in that limb can be reduced. So do not ever feel that there is no hope for me, because there is. Now, these in stage 4, they often require custom compression garments and or adjustable short stretch compression garments. But there are garments that will work for them. These patients have also often gone through years or decades without effective management, and compliance with management and maintenance compression is crucial for them. Now, here is why I'm telling you guys that I wanted to go through the stages, and that is because you do not want to get to a place where you're not managing yourself. I got to tell you guys, if you want to find out more ways to support Live Today, please go out to www.live-today.org. You guys, as usual, have been a fantastic audience, very engaging. You got to stay tuned, because next month we got some special things for you. We have some special announcements. I thought I was ready to make them tonight, but I'm not quite ready yet. I want some things in order. But I want you guys to realize that I want you guys to live. And I want you to get to a place in your life where you recognize that I am going to be present and I am going to take charge of my life and live today and every day. God bless you.